Hi guys, Jesterak back again in Warhammer 40,000 Inquisitor Martyr. This is still the alpha build and is not necessarily representative of what the final game will look like. Okay, so I've got enough points up to do a tarot quest. The crafting bug is still in place, which is a pain in the ass. I'm just going to move the microphone. Stay. Good microphone. Okay, so we're going to do ourselves a tarot quest, but before we quickly do that, let's check out how we're going in the Tenumbra section, or subsector, I should say. Okay, so we're slowly progressing towards the final rank here, which is lovely. Oh, incidentally, let's just quickly jump back to the command thingy. In the last episode, we got ourselves a new inoculator piece, but it didn't show up straight away. It's this one here, Invigorator. Restores 50% of your maximum HP upon injection. So we're going to try and run with that one instead of the coagulant, which restores 10% of your maximum HP per second for 5 seconds. Still going to run with absorbent, which restores 50% of your maximum suppression upon injection. Okay, tarot quest time. I'm going to go trader again because I really want to try and get some applicable armor for myself. What have we got? Bloodshed. No, we want unending. And we want resilience. 25% extra hit points to all enemies, but it gives us new items. Right. Unending? Grants a rare item. Yeah, that's what we're doing. Okay, I've run a few missions as well, and I think we've gained a couple of levels. So once we've finished with this fight, we'll take a look at opening up some boxes and doing some stuff. Allocating skill points. Yeah, that's what I'm after. Not sure if I've completed any heroic deeds that give us anything interesting. I know I've completed a couple of the fate point quests, hence the reason we've got fate points to spend. Oh look, I have joined the game. Oh, and this room is poisoned. Lovely. Just what we need. Okay. I don't think the poison works against our suppression, though I'm not entirely certain of that, so don't quote me on it as yet. Okay. Our suppression seems to be going up, so I'm guessing it doesn't. Or if it does, then it's not enough to make too much of a difference. Our suppression regain might be higher than the loss. There we go. So far, the crafting bug is really the only sort of big one I've seen. I've had a couple of times where I've gotten stuck in items, jumped and gotten stuck on a door. Or I haven't been able to destroy a door is another one. Although I think that one I probably could have found a workaround for. I ended up just jumping over the door when that occurs. Okay. Lovely. What better way to spend my birthday than smiting the enemies of the Empire? In the name of the Emperor. Yes, that's what we're doing. Okay. Lovely. Hopefully sound's coming through good. Ugh. Still having a few hiccups and issues with OBS for some reason at the moment. Okay. I did buy myself a grav gun. Or grav pistol, I should say. I do want to try out a few more weapon loadouts, I suppose. This or the Greatsword are still my choice as far as melee goes. Oh, crap. But yeah, we've still got a few options to try out as far as ranged weaponry goes. Okay. That is a nice inoculator. Oh, and we got a regen thingy. Might go take that out, hey? Lovely. Hey, don't come in here from the other room. Stay there and wait for me. Bloody patient, or impatient, I should say. Oh, and we got no jumps. There we go. Okay. Come closer, my new friend. What are you? Don't know what that percentagey thing is. Up where it's next to the Hellbrute name. Probably look that sort of thing up, I guess. Well, admittedly, there is sort of a severe lack of information when it comes to a lot of that sort of thing at this point in time. These guys aren't really attacking me for some reason either. What did we get? Oh, there we go. We got another grab pistol by the look of it. Okay, what does this map look like? Go around this way. And then around, and then come back into that room, I think. Seems to be a viable option. Okay. Down they go. I'm guessing there's not a great deal of enemies in those rooms. We seem to have taken out the bulk of what's around. I remember when the Chaos Space Marines used to pose quite a threat. One-on-one or one-on-two, they don't seem to be too bad now. Okay. Difficulty does not seem to scale with your character. There we go, melee unit. Which way did I say I was going to go? I'll come up to here, and then I'll backtrack a bit, and then come up and around. No crates. I'm really looking forward to some more content and whatnot for this. Just a rehash as well. Apparently that crafting bug is a known bug, and they have got a fix worked out. It just hasn't been implemented yet. Apparently it's due in the next update. Okay. Anything in here? Nope, it's an empty room. Okay. One of the first completely empty rooms I think I've seen. I've seen corridor sections that have been empty, but never a full room before. Hi guys, I'm Jester, I'm here to exterminate you. Okay. I still like the squelchy sound they make. Okay. At the moment, holding down the mouse wheel is what you do in order to rotate the screen. That gets a bit awkward when you're trying to rotate the screen and attack and, yeah. But you don't seem to be able to remap that particular command at the moment. Just about everything else you can, but not that. Go and get this little corridor done. And off to the last room. Well, what's left of the last room? I think we've already done some of the enemies in here. And this will then be the completion of another tarot card quest. Hopefully we get some assault armor. That's what I'm actually after. Yes. Some Whatchamahoozit tier assault armor. Artificer. That's the one I'm after, the purple ones. So you go with my Eviscerator. And we're done. Ooh, sorry about that. Okay. It was very... Actually, that was very easy. But I still enjoyed it. Let's get rid of this stuff. Oh, it was a grab gun, not a grab pistol. And there. Okay, first things first, let's allocate some skills. We've got 3 points to go with. We are trying to get to here. The enhanced organs grants 10% maximum HP and max suppression. I think we only need these... 2, 3. There we go. Okay, that's done. We've reached that. Wonderful. What haven't we got here? We haven't unlocked this one. With every successful deflect, 5 suppression points are regained. Okay. Have we got any points? We do have points available down here. Okay. Increase to warp resistance. Lovely. As you can see, our attack and defense is still only at level 1. And our account rank, I'm guessing that's that number there, is slowly making its way up. Is that what that is? Maybe. How many points have I deflected? I deflect 9% of points, okay. Of damage, obviously. Okay. We have got the Mark II Melter Gun, so we're going to learn that. And let's see, confiscated items, normal. Let's go through, grab all these, and we'll take a look at what we got. Ooh, there we go, assault armor, lovely. Hey, well, did I get that down there? Ooh, we got more stuff. None of that's going to be any use to us. Okay, let's just take a look at what we got here. 8 defense, 45 damage reduction, 4.3% deflect, 5.9% melee damage, and 6.4 warp resistance with 114 on our assault jump. 195 suppression, 5.7 warp resistance, 6.1 physical resistance, 11 defense, 45 damage reduction again. So we'll lose our deflect and our melee damage. And it's the same on the assault jump, but the added defense as well. So let's go for that. Oh, that kind of looks a bit awesome. Yep, I think I'm happy with that. And what are you, Inoculator? You're a red and a orange. That's not much use to me with a capacity of 17. Okay, let's break down what we got and move on. Can we get this yet? No. I figured that was a bit too much to ask, but I asked anyway. Get rid of all of these. Okay, let's sell that inoculator. Have you got anything else of overly major interest? No. Okay. Let's get the rest of these done. More normals. Okay. That's the tarot reward for traitor. Which we didn't get any assault armor in. We just got two lots of sentinel. Well, we got assault there, but it wasn't high tier. Okay. Neural implant. So that's that one there. 7 attack, 5.3 warp resistance, 13 critical hit strength, and 7.5 damage on whirling attack skills, which will be beneficial to this weapon. 12 critical hit strength, 157 HP, and damage to piercing skills. I think I'll keep the one I've got equipped. It's not worth quite as much. But I'm already doing a crap load of damage on my whirling skills. And the extra HP itself, I think, is a bit more useful to me. It's not a lot of hit point bonus, but it is some. Gonna hold on to both of those for now as well. Main reason being, I haven't tried that class of Crusader yet. So I don't really know what's going to be in my best interest as far as build items are concerned. Still can't get it? No. Money's going up through the roof, though. Let's take a look in here. More peppily bits. So we've got three lots of Sentinel armor and one of demo. We've got the Thule bolt pistol. A good tier bolt pistol is another item I am looking for, so we can test that out. And as I said, I've got a grab pistol here. I could probably get rid of the greatswords at this point in time, but on the same note, it's not really doing me anything to keep it or get rid of it. So, right. Have I actually got any tarot point things left? It's really hard to tell because they don't update properly. You've pretty much got to leave the game and come back. What haven't we done? Increased rare weapon. Yeah, we'll go increase rare weapon find. We'll be fighting limited to Nurgle type opponents. Again, we'll go the standard resilience and unending. Yeah, not enough fate points. That's what I thought. I wouldn't have had enough anyway. Yeah, anyway. Okay. What are we going to go for? Let's go for a small purge. We'll see how fast we can knock this out. Orders. Purge them all. A place of worship has been desecrated. Which has made people very upset. And now we're off to kill people. Yay! Can't hear water lapping, which means I'm guessing it's an indoor mission again. Yep. That is one thing I am obviously very much looking... Holy crap. Looking forward to is going to be new sort of terrain types and map variants. As well as new mission types other than just the purge, assassinate, or collect missions. Oh, and there's the ones where we've got to go shut down enemy artillery. In the form of AA guns, by memory. And just die! Stop running away. Thank you. Look at my healing numbers going. Hey, why are my numbers on screen? I only just noticed that. Okay, it's only healing numbers. That's alright. They all just blew themselves up. I love when that happens. Okay. Make them all dead. Kind of hard to see where you're actually targeting. Ow. Hey, come here, Space Marine. No, no, no. Whack him. Don't run away. Big wuss bag. Thank you. Okay, we are overwhelmed and slowed. That's okay, our health is still pretty good. Come on, give me a jump. Jump. And multi-slash. And spin. And now just, you know, whack into it. As you can see, once you are overwhelmed, you get knocked down by just about everything. Well, basic sort of ballistic attacks like these, you're okay with, but anything that sort of like that, or that amounts as a heavy attack, be it missiles or something like that, it will knock you on your ass when you're overwhelmed. There we go. I'm pretty sure I take less damage currently when I'm overwhelmed as well as a result of where I've allocated skills, or skill points, I should say. Okay, a bit of backtracking. As much as the helmet that I'm wearing currently is kind of funny looking, I'm loving the actual rest of the armor. Interesting looking, jetpack as well. That said, like, the seals and little doodads on my armor are just sort of flopping around like crazy. Okay. Truth be told, I haven't actually played any of NeoCore's other games. They do the bunch of Van Helsing games. This is sort of making me a bit curious about giving them a try. From what I've seen and been told about them, they are very similar to what we're playing here in the general gameplay aspect. I do enjoy this sort of game. Okay. The only downside is they are often quite linear. And repetitive, obviously. Okay. Get these guys out of the way. Come on. Damn it. The suppression is real. Now we're overwhelmed. That fixed that. I'll just use the damn attack. Didn't quite have somebody targeted properly. And as I've mentioned, if you don't have things targeted properly, it often won't use the attack at all. Shit. Come on. Spinny thing. Okay, he's down at least. Didn't actually mean to jump then. You do have to allow between when you press a button and when it actually does the attack, there is a bit of a tiny delay as well. That is something you've got to really try and factor in, especially when you're trying to do things like the assault jumps. There we go. Managed to time it that time. You'll see... Oh, crap. You'll see him coming through with a big melee attack or something that would generally knock you over, but is avoidable. So you would use the assault jump to get away from it. Except for the fact that quite often... Hey, where was the kaboom? Except for the fact that quite often you can't quite time it right.
Okay. Last little stretch. Come on. Okay. A few more grenades for the last little room that probably won't have a lot in it, I wouldn't think. We've already gone up against a dread. Well, it might. We've had a couple. I've had a couple that I've come across where I've had multiple dreadnoughts. Like this one. There you go. Lovely. Okay, attacks like that, once you're suppressed, are a pain in the ass. Come on. What do we got? We got a couple of little guys left. Well, no little guys left. One of these guys and a dreadnought. That should be easy enough to deal with. Okay. Health is good. Suppression is starting to go down. Once it goes down a little bit more, probably just as it hits the red, I think I'll use my inoculator. There we go. Have a grenade. The Nurgle Dreadnoughts do seem to be one of the hardier ones that I've come across, I think. My experience with them thus far, at least, suggests that. And there we go. Mission complete. Let's get out of there. And I think I just got another schematic as well. Yep, I did. Okay, let's learn the schematic. What is it? Suppression shield Mach 2. Yeah, look, as I said, little thing's going absolutely berserk. Okay, we did get a green bolt pistol. So in the next episode, what we'll probably do is just go nuts. Grab that bolt pistol out. We might give dual-wielding bolt pistols a bit of a go. But that's where we're going to finish off. So for the right now, this is Jester Arc, and this is Warhammer 40,000 Inquisitor Martyr. Please feel free to hit the button of appreciation and whatnot down the bottom. Thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll see you guys next time.